The Karnataka verdict has thrown up a hung assembly, and now it comes down to what decision Governor Vajubhai Vala makes next. Vajubhai Vala has been a BJP politician, and now in the constitutional post of governor, his next decision will decide the fate of the Karnataka government. So what are the options before the governor? In scenario one, he allows the single largest party to form the next government. This would, of course, be advantage BJP, but they would have to prove their majority on the floor of the House, which would not be an easy task since they are still short of a simple majority. In this case, the Congress is also likely to move courts to counter a decision like this. In scenario two, the governor could invite the Congress and JDS combined to form the next government. Together, the two parties are well placed with the numbers, but he will also have to consider that this was not a pre-poll alliance. In the third and most unlikely scenario of all, he could call for a re-election if no clear combination emerges. Now, while one cannot predict what the governor will decide, he does have guidelines to work with. The 1998 Sarkaria Commission recommendations have a clear order of preference in which at number one is to call a pre-poll alliance, which doesn't exist in this case. At number two, a single largest party with support of others could be called. And at number three, in this order of preference, it would be a post-electoral coalition with full support. It is not just the Sarkaria Commission, there is another commission in 2010 which has similar recommendations, where in the first recommendation or the first order of preference is that the group with the largest pre-poll alliance is invited and then the single largest party with support of others. If he follows these recommendations, he is likely to go with scenario one, where the BJP is invited to prove its majority. What would also bolster that argument is the SR Bommai case, where guidelines have been set to invite the leader of the party commanding majority in the House or the single largest party. But, and this is a big but, governors in the recent past, after state elections in Goa and Manipur, have chosen to ignore these guidelines and go with the coalition that presented the numbers. In those two cases, it was advantage BJP. So what will Governor Vala choose to do? Well, that is anybody's guess.